money that you could give the stems to, or you could just chop them up and throw them into a salad that you're going to have along with your pizza. So we're just going to get some leaves ready. We can really put the whole leaf on the pizza. Nice. And one thing that you'll notice, that dark green leaf, it really has some texture to it. A little bit different than a lettuce. It's just full of sunshine and minerals. It's just amazing and so delicious. I put spinach in omelets, I put it in quiche, I put it in soup, and of course, just plain eating some spinach. It's really, really awesome. So you should try that too. Just try eating a piece of spinach right now with me. I love it. Okay. Now, of course, when we're chopping, we are always remembering to keep the knife on the table. Point down. Take your time. And we're just making these little zucchini medallions. So I happen to have a zucchini. I think it's going to be delicious. You can really use any kind of vegetable. So we're going to have some zucchini on there. Good amount. I guess we'll just finish the last little bit here. Maybe a tiny bit more. Okay, so when I'm getting close to my fingers, I'm just going to stop there. I think that's good. Okay, and then finally we're going to do some mushrooms. You might want to just cut that part off and just do little slices. And you can really use a butter knife for this. I don't happen to have a butter knife, but just going to do little thin slices of mushroom. Mushrooms are so cool because they grow in the dark. Spinach needs light. Zucchini needs light. Mushrooms do not. They grow in caves. Okay. All right, so we have mushrooms. We've got our zucchini. We've got spinach. This thing is the onion. This is going to be now. What I like to do when I cut an onion open, besides smell it, smells so good, is to notice how absolutely beautiful it is on the inside. You know, basically, our food is really just another kind of art. And not only is this a purple onion, which is such a beautiful color all by itself, but it has an amazing pattern on the inside. So cool. So, again, keeping the point on the table, we're just going to cut a few little slivers of this onion. And what you want to do is you want to take the skin off the outside. Take this little skin. And you know what I learned recently that's such a great idea? Take all these little bits. Whenever we're, like, I could even take the mushrooms, but especially something, mushrooms are kind of different. They're kind of spongy. But things like the little tops of a carrot, the little tops of green peppers, take anything like this, put it in a Ziploc, stick it in your freezer, and then you can make a soup stock out of it. It's amazing. Lots of nice soup ahead of me. Okay, so just little bits of this Spanish onion. This is going to go right on the top of our pizza. Okay, so we're ready. Ready to move back over and just see how things are going here in the yeast department. Okay, so I think it's good and dissolved. And now we are going to actually transfer this bigger bowl. Job in your kitchen. You might hold the spoon while somebody else pours the olive oil. So we're going to put 4 tablespoons in here. 1, just till it comes to the tippy top of the spoon. 2, 3, 4. 4 tablespoons. Means that our oven is up to 400 degrees. So that's fantastic. I preheated it. So we do need 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and we use sea salt. Pretty cool. They actually take ocean water and evaporate the water out so that we can have delicious salt that has sea minerals. Now this might be a good thing to do not over your bowl, okay? Because if you have quick running salt, you want to make sure you don't have too much that goes in there. So again, you want to make sure it is level and in it goes, okay? And finally, we are going to put 1 3/4 cups of flour. So these are dry cup measures. This was a wet cup measure when we got our water. But this is dry cup measure that helps you when you level it to know you put really exactly 1 cup in there. And then we need 3/4 cup. So that I found my 1/4 cup, and you're going to need 3 quarters. Okay, 1, 2. Okay. So now comes combining time. So at first you can really use a spoon to kind of begin to get it to go together into a dough. But what I did is I put parchment paper down. I put parchment paper so that I could just put my dough directly on to the table, but not sticky up the table too badly. Okay. So here's our dough. Now, I think what we're going to do is add a little bit more of our flour, spread it out, so that we can actually roll this dough until it doesn't feel sticky anymore. A little bit more flour. We're going to work it in. So if you knead it, you're going to use this part of your hand, and you're going to fold it over. And you're picking up a little bit more flour as you go, then you can fold it again. I don't know if you you've ever seen them in the pizzeria, making pizza dough and throwing it up and catching it. It's always amazing. They make pizza for a living. Alright, so this is still a little bit sticky. Feels really fun and good, doesn't it? Really the funnest part is rolling out the dough. Okay, just catching that extra flour. It does take a little while. So in the end, we will have added quite a bit of flour. But now it's really feeling like a solid dough. So soft and nice. Just keep folding it over, picking up a little bit more flour. This dough is ready. So now I'll transfer my vegetables to my colander. Bring those over. Ooh, you know what? I think there's one more little step we have to do. We have to grate some cheese. Take our cheese, mozzarella, and you know when you use a grater, you're always paying attention to where your fingers are, so that they are safely away. So yeah, usually I do my grating standing up. Here, obviously, this is a stand-up kind of kitchen. But even in my home kitchen, I usually use a grater standing up because it just gives me a little more pressure. Okay, so. I think we're going to need about 2 cups of cheese. Good. Okay. So, that nice cheese. All right, so I've got my tomato sauce. One of my favorite tomato sauces is made by Newman's Own. So that's my preference. Socceroni has a few more little flavors in there. So I'm just going to put a little olive oil on my pizza pan. Spread it around. Now this is a smaller dough. The dough is bigger than I need for this particular dough. But we're just going to kind of work this dough until we have kind of a nice shape. Have to be perfect at all, but you want to try not to have holes in the bottom. So so I kind of use my body weight. So, yeah. I mean, I don't know if you're a thin crust person or a thick crust person. I tend to kind of like mine on the thinner side. So just try to make it even. And that looks pretty good to me. Okay, so we're just going to probably use, why don't we start with a half cup. Just fill your sauce with a half cup. And see how much it takes to cover it. You don't have to, now when you get to this point, you want to be careful not to put your sauce and your cheese all the way up to the edge. You want a nice little crust at the edge. So, boy, that really smells yummy. So this sauce, I can see, already has some vegetables in it. It has peppers. Do whatever you want. I'm going to get